The concept of how viruses mutate and why some mutations matter and others don't is complex. Viruses are constantly making copies of themselves, and sometimes in that process, they make a small change that may or may not matter. Consider this simple sentence. Eat a pie. This is our original virus. Somewhere along the way, a change might turn that into ate a pie. And then a new sentence keeps getting repeated. If the ate a pie variant is twice as infectious, then it spreads twice as fast, and pretty soon there aren't any more copies of the original eat a pie. So then another mutation happens, and we get the ace a pie variant. This one doesn't spread very fast. It has a local outbreak and gets a little attention, but the ate a pie variant is dominant and outcompetes other variants. But then the ate a pie virus makes a change, making it ate a pea. That variant spreads more easily than any of the previous and takes over. After a while, it mutates again to ate a bay. This one doesn't work at all. Without the pea, it can't go any further. It's a failed variant, of which there are many, many more. But meanwhile, ate a pea also mutated to ate a ape. This one is scary. It's scary because it's even more easily spread between hosts than earlier variants, and because the way we've been recognizing the virus is by looking at that P in the word. When the P is at the beginning of the word, it's easy to see. But now it's in the middle, and harder to recognize. This is where booster vaccines come in. Their job is to look for the P in the third word, because as immune memory fades with time, it may increasingly fail to find the hidden P. So there you have it. In a matter of seconds, we went from eat a pie to ate a ape. Now imagine copying that sentence a few trillion times. You'll end up with a lot more mutations. Sometimes for the good, and other times we aren't as lucky. Viruses and their variants may seem complex, but thanks to science, it can be as easy as pie or ape.